this is obviously a time when we think about new beginnings and resolutions, but it's also really necessary, and it's unity tradition to think of this as a time of letting go first, because how can we accept that which is coming our way if our hands are full? We have to let go what we're carrying. We have to let go of our burdens, and so we can empty ourselves to accept the blessings that are coming to us. And so today we're going to have a sacred water ceremony, which is a ceremony of letting go. This is a wonderful way of using the elements, which have been used since time immemorial by ancient healers to clear and cleanse and prepare the way. And just a note for those who have joined late, you can maybe grab a bowl of water or a cup of water. And if that's inconvenient, just imagine. You can just use your imagination during the ceremony. But first, I'd like to say a few things about letting go. Our body knows how to let go. So try it right now. Just take a deep breath and exhale. Feel your chest falling. And you know, every time you do that, you're tapping into so many things. Your parasympathetic nervous system is telling your organs to relax. It's resetting your neurochemistry subtly but powerfully to let go of anxiety. Your heartbeat actually slows down just a little bit. You're tapping into this thing called the vagus nerve. But you're tapping into the spiritual act of exhaling. And so our bodies know how to let go. We don't have to look far to see the leaves and the trees know how to let go. And it's necessary for their growth. It's necessary for the recycling of nature, but for the growth of the tree itself. And also thinking of animals like or mammals, the crab. Actually, the crab isn't a mammal. It's a technically, what, an arachnid? But the crab lets go of its shell. And when it does, what happens? It grows, and the new shell grows back stronger. So if this crab were to refuse to let go of its shell, it would never grow, and it would never become stronger. So we're one with nature, and God's reality is reflected everywhere. So there's something, there's a lesson that we can take from nature. Reverend Marilyn Pels also told me of one of the Native American tribes believes that for every moment of expansion, spiritual expansion, such as you learn something, you have an epiphany, you grow. For every moment of spiritual expansion, there should be an equivalent or even greater moment of spiritual contraction. So once again, this theme of inhaling and exhaling, of letting go, is apparent there. So if our physical bodies, if nature, if all these things depend upon letting go, our very spirituality, our very spiritual growth, and our destiny to realize more and more each day our divinity depends upon this letting go. We've got to let go of certain things. The Buddhist author Jack Kornfield said, "In the end, just three things matter: how well we have lived, how well we have loved, and how well we have learned to let go." Isn't that amazing? In the end, just three things matter: how well we have lived, how well we have loved, and how well we have learned to let go. So what are we willing to let go of is our focus question today. What are we sick and tired of? What is ready to be released at this time? And each of us has our own burdens to carry, whether that be anger, fear, guilt, resentment, feelings of depression, bad habits, false beliefs that we carry that no longer serve us. We're not meant to hold on to these things forever. They're meant to teach us lessons and then we can let them go. So let's take a moment to focus on what we'd like to let go of. I'm actually going to read from a book by Brené Brown called The Gifts of Imperfection. And she talks about letting go. Letting go of what people think. Letting go of perfectionism. Letting go of powerlessness. Letting go of scarcity. Letting go of fear of the dark. Letting go of the need for certainty. Letting go of the need to compare ourselves to someone else. Letting go of exhaustion as a status symbol. Letting go of anxiety as a lifestyle, or productivity equaling self-worth. Letting go of self-doubt and the words, I'm supposed to. And letting go of being cool and always in control. So right now, I would like for you to take your journal or a piece of paper and just meditate for a moment and write down some of the things that you are ready to let go. And let's take a few minutes to do this. So just make a final note or two, maybe jot down a bullet that you can come back to. And if you have a bowl of water nearby, just make sure it's close to you, or a cup of water. I invite you to close your eyes if you're comfortable. And take a cleansing breath. Let's affirm this as a sacred space, a safe place, knowing that we are not alone, because we are surrounded and supported not only by this community, but by the infinite power and presence of the One Source, inviting in whatever guides, angels, healers, power animals we wish, ancestors. Let's just breathe into the safety, the unconditional love of this room right now, letting your shoulders relax into it. And let's draw our attention mentally to the sacred nature of water. In the ancient healing traditions, many elements were used to cleanse and heal, but water has a particularly unique quality of cleansing and clearing and preparing the way. And water is ancient. More than half of the molecules in all water were once ingested by the dinosaurs, it is theorized. The water in your cup or bowl is said to be older than the sun. Because water is ancient and it has recycled over and over to every corner of the planet, it is also said that the bowl contains at least a few molecules that Jesus drank from, that the Buddha drank from, that Muhammad drank from, that every person in history that you've heard from of has drank from. Your bowl contains a few molecules that have been touched by everyone. And water is powerful. Think about the Grand Canyon. It was created by a form of water, ice, carving out mountainsides. Water is the great solvent. It breaks down rocks, smooths them into smooth stones, and shapes continents over time. And most of all, it sustains life. You are made up of 2/3 water, and your brain is 80% water. Water is life-giving. So in this consciousness of water as a tool to help us resolve and let go, I want you to call to your consciousness some of those things that you wrote down on your piece of paper. What things do you wish to let go? Not viewing these things as an enemy, but viewing these things as a teacher. And the lesson is done. Say to yourself, or say out loud, I no longer identify with you. You are an old energy form that I'm ready to let go of. And say, you have no power over me. Knowing that we store these things in our emotional body and that they are dynamic and we can dismiss them whenever we want to, I want you now to open your eyes and place your fingertips just inside of the bowl where you can feel the water. And if you don't have a bowl, just imagine yourself touching the edge of a lake or a stream. And now imagine wherever this thing is, this thought is, this habit is, whatever it is you wish to let go, imagine it just gently losing its power and traveling slowly down your arms, into your hands, and being released through your fingertips into the water. Gently inviting the water to take it away. The water is part of the one expression. It's part of the source. It receives and transforms it. It clears it away. It carries it away with ease and grace. So say one more time, and say it aloud if you can. I release you into the water. I set you free. And then visualize whatever this is being carried out through the great lakes and streams and rivers and out into the ocean where it is absorbed and transmuted into a different energy. It's gone. And take a deep cleansing breath. Just releasing everything that no longer serves you, relaxing your shoulders and feeling and recognizing this lightness that took the place of whatever heaviness it was. So as you dry your hands, I want you to think to yourself, I want you to give this water a blessing. And I'm going to close this moment with a prayer. I give thanks for the opportunity to let go and change my mind whenever I want to. I'm grateful that I can declare a new beginning in this moment, and in the next moment, and tomorrow, and the next day. I trust the universe to give me all of the resources that I need to step into this newer version of myself that I give birth to. I know that God's blessings are so abundant in my life. And I'm so grateful for the people in this room right now as we send unconditional love to each other and acceptance for each other as dynamic, growing expressions of the one source. I know that whenever I am weak and whenever I forget, that reminders will come my way. And knowing that the consciousness of the people in this room is full of unconditional love and safety and peace. And so it is done.